Sure that you mute your cell phones, things like that, so that we don't disturb. We are live streaming this. We don't want to disturb the audience members on the other side of the internet, and we want to make sure our students get a great concert out of this. That being said, if you look on this inside cover of your program, there is a QR code that you can scan that has the program notes that the composers have written about their pieces. All right. Today's concert's all about vistas, all about scenes that composers have painted of beauty, whether it be outside scenes or whether it be something from the heart. And so I hope you guys really enjoy this. The first piece was written by Stephen Reinecke. It's called River of Life. Stephen Reinecke is the pops conductor for the Houston Symphony Orchestra and writes a ton of band music, usually sounds very operatic, Wagnerian, that kind of stuff. But this was written about the river of life, as in the quotes that are found in Genesis. All right. Our next piece was a contender for an animated action movie. It's based on The White Seal by Rudyard Kipling. One of the major motion picture companies wanted to do an action adventure cartoon based on The White Seal. The book opens up with a poem that's called The Seal Lullaby. All right. Now, ultimately, the movie wasn't made because they decided to make Kung Fu Panda instead. But this is Eric Wheeler's The Seal Lullaby.
Thank you.
so I would end up rehearsing and conducting a whole bunch of groups and things like that. And so what you're about to see are two of our conducting students performing as conductors on pieces that they have completely rehearsed, and now they get to perform the piece in public. All right, so I hope you guys enjoy the next two pieces. Our first conductor is Lance Tinkle.
I'm sorry, I'm slaying it.
Thank you.
But in order to understand this piece, you have to understand that it's written about, it's inspired by a composer at the turn of the 20th century named Charles Ives. Charles Ives probably predated most of the giant innovations that happened in the 20th century. Nobody knew about them, though, because he decided early on, or he figured out early on, that in order to be a composer and write music freely, he couldn't make his living as a composer. And so he started the Hart Insurance Company, which became Hartford, the one with the giant elk on it, made millions and millions of dollars. Most of his music was hidden in a barn in Connecticut and wasn't discovered until well after he died. Right? And so this piece was written about a satirical character that Charles Ives created called Rollo. Rollo is a concert goer that knows what good music is and knows what kind of music he likes, and it's usually something that's popular, repetitive, things like that, all right? And so David Maslanka, the composer of this piece, took that character and made a nice little lighthearted piece about Rollo taking a walk through the countryside or through the city, wherever you want to imagine where he took a walk. It's a nice, cute little piece. You're going to hear a lot of fun little sounds in here. We have a kazoo section for this piece, so I hope you guys enjoy Rollo Takes a Walk.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So give yourselves a round of applause, please. So if you are a parent of a student up here, think back to sixth grade and all those horrendous sounds that came out of their instruments, and now they're able to do things like this. So we really appreciate your patience and your support of them as they grew up into these fine musicians that I get to work with while they're here at McMurry. The next piece is written by a friend of mine that I got to know while I was teaching at Northwest Missouri State University. His name is Gavin Mint. He's a French horn player. His